Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. I have an empties video for you today. I guess this is my summer empties. We're moving, so I got rid of a lot more than I normally would have, but there are a lot of actual empties in here, and I'm just going to try and speed through this as much as I can. So a few months ago, I received referral skincare, and this came with 15 days worth of skincare for you to really, more than 15, it came with 21 days of skincare, and my skin really did like it, but I looked at the actual price if I were to buy this skincare routine, and it's a lot of money, and I don't think it's so great that it's worth the money for it. But yeah, all of these are done, so they're gone. I have this Ecru New York Acacia Protein BB Cream for hair and beauty balm for hair. I used this a few times, I didn't notice anything with it. This part downwards is permanently straightened, this part is natural minus a keratin treatment I just did that I will be reviewing. You'll see a review video in several weeks, but we'll see. I'm getting rid of it. It's mainly out, but I didn't notice anything with it. I have the Tresemme Thermal Creations Heat Protectant. I love this stuff. Not for really any reason. I feel like it works and it's cheap, so I really like it. This one didn't, it's really expensive now. This used to be like $3 and now it's like $10. I just bought whatever one online was cheapest from Tresemme and it seems to be working well for me, but I've repurchased this several times and I will continue to as long as it's on sale, but definitely from the brand. I have this Helen Elaine Argan and Neroli Moisturizer. I got this from Perpix and I used it a few times and I didn't really love it, so I'm getting rid of it now. I have the Acure Quick Fix Correcting Balm Argan Oil Plus Star Flower. I got this from the M Squared Brands Blogger Boxes. I think this is one of the first ones I received and I did enjoy this, but I keep getting so many products from them that I love and I feel like my skin food from Melita acts amazingly and I don't really have a need for this one. But it's already very used and I've had it for a long time, so I think I've had this for about a year now. So I'm just throwing it out. I have the Vera Wang Princess Satiny Body Lotion, and I also have the polish, which I forgot to throw out, but I'm going to grab that and put it in the garbage. I've had this for years now. It says 24 months. I've had it for like 4 years. Matt bought this for me for Christmas 1 year, along with the actual Princess perfume. It came in like a package, and I really did enjoy these. This one irritated my skin a little bit. I don't do well with heavily scented fragrances, like not perfumey fragrances. On my skin, I do have eczema. I break out with like little bumps like that all over my body. So I try to avoid anything that'll affect that. So I used part of this, but honestly, most of it went to waste from this at least. The polish I really did enjoy because I could put it on and rinse it off and the scent stayed behind, but it didn't not irritate my skin because I rinsed it off. I have a bunch of razor cartridges in here. The Venus, the sensitive, gentle ones. I have a used up sample of the Le Petit Marseillais Gentle Body Wash. I got this one from Influencer to review, and I love it. Le Petit Marseillais actually sent me a full size of their vanilla one, and I love it, love it, love it. I'm still using it because I like to switch through body washes, so I don't get bored, but I really highly recommend. I have another Helen Elaine product. It's the Lavender and White Willow Mask Exfoliant. I used this a few times in order to give it a review, but it wasn't that positive. I didn't really see a point in this. I didn't see anything happening to my skin from it. I have a Batiste dry shampoo. This is the dark brown one. I really love Batiste. I don't care too much for this one. My friend Emily gave me this because she had gotten like blonde highlights and it just didn't work anymore for her, but it was okay. I still prefer the original and I really love the cherry one for scent, but the original works well for me, so that's what I normally buy. And now they come in like double the size. They come in, this is 200 mils, they come in 400 mils, and I usually find it for like $11 or $12. I have a very old bedhead product. This is the Ego Boost Split End Mender Leave-In Conditioner. This is done. And I've had this since I graduated high school when I first got my Japanese permanent hair straightening done. I no longer get that done because it's just too expensive. I love it, but it's way too expensive for me to keep affording. But I got this there, they gave it to me, and it worked very well, but I don't have too many issues with split ends anymore because now my shampoos that I use are so good that there's really no point of this, and there's just other products that I like better for helping split ends. I have an Eva NYC Up All Night Volumizing Spray for added texture. I tried using this. I'm not a really big person for texture and volumizing my hair. I like my hair very flat. I have naturally crazy curly hair, like it's very puffy, So unlike many people that have straight hair that has no life to it that don't like it, I like my hair being very flat and straight with no life to it. If I want life to it, I'll curl it. I have the Revlon Colorstay 2-in-1 Angled Cajal Liner. I received this for free last year from Revlon, and I tried it out many times. I tried it out recently many times just to make sure I was sure. And yeah, this just comes out of my waterline really easily. It's not dark enough. Like this, it's in the color graphite, so it's not supposed to be black, but I don't like the look of a gray eyeliner. I have a few of these OGX samples that I got at Generation Beauty several years ago, and I don't use this brand of shampoo, so I don't mess around with that. I will stick to my shampoos that I use every day. Well, every week. I have the Essence Volume Stylist 18-Hour Curl and Hold Mascara. I highly recommend Essence mascaras. They're very affordable and just very, very good. I loved this one. I do like my Lash Princess one way better. I like the purple and the blue one. Those are just like my favorite of all time, basically. But this one's also very good depending on what you're looking for. This one's more for curling. I have the Healthy Sexy Hair Soy Renewal Beach Spray, another texturizing product that I don't use. And I used part of it up and it's really old as well, so that's gone. Random sample of conditioner. I don't even know. This is probably like 10 years old and it's gone now. I have a few lip products. I have the Lancome Color Design Wannabe Cream. So this one I'm getting rid of even though I really did enjoy it, but it's just very old and I don't use it anymore. And this was, I think, part of my declutter videos. So this is going. I also have the Juicy Tube Raspberry Ice from Lancome. That's also going. It's very old and since it's a lip gloss, it's not as hygienic to keep around. And then I have my Rimmel London Lasting Finish Lipstick in the color Dizzy that I decluttered. I haven't actually shown you that declutter video yet. That will be out and then you'll see everything that I got rid of. I'll just show them quickly and not explain them and then throw them in the garbage. So I actually have a straightener. My aunt bought this for my birthday 2 years ago. This is the Velectric and it broke. I don't know what happened to it. I feel like I may have dropped it, but it completely cracked down on the side and down the center as well, so my hair just gets stuck in it every time and it burns really easily because of that. So I'm kind of sad about it, but I do really love my new me straightener. I don't see any problems with it and I got it for like $30 when it was on sale. Oh, I have like a bunch of old ass lashes inside of here that I'm not even gonna show you because I can't get this open, but I have a bunch of really old used lashes in here. I've worn these before. These are like Ardell lashes and they're really old. I don't remember what they were called, but they look like this. Ardell's okay, but like pretty good, but there are cheaper alternatives that I like way better and there are expensive alternatives that I love. This is the Rimmel Wake Me Up Foundation. This is old. I'll just link down below a playlist of my whole declutter series. My most recent one, because obviously the old one is old and those products are long gone. Another declutter Essence All I Need Concealer Palette. I have a few more lipsticks. I have like a Maybelline one, Burt's Bees Smashbox lip balm from Lipsil, I think. This, yeah, I completely finished this one up. I loved it. Rimmel London Bite Beauty makes me sad, and like random lip liners from brands that I don't know. I finished up my Mychel sugar cleanser. It's cut open because I literally scraped every last inch of it out. I refuse to throw it out with anything in there. I love that stuff. I will for sure repurchase once I'm out. But this was actually the first PR product I got. Was a package from Mychel Beauty. So thank you so much for getting me started in this world of getting makeup in exchange for reviews and all of that. So sentimental, but I'm not gonna keep a broken thing around. I have two deodorants. They're both secret ones. One of them is the pH Balance Baby Powder and the other one is the Clear Gel in Vava Vanilla. This is my favorite. I always repurchase this one. I have a sample of the Dr. Brandt Lips in Full Effect, lip plumping, whatever. It didn't do anything for me. Awful mascara. This is the Almay One Coat Mega Volume. I'm sorry, Almay. I don't really use your products, but I got this in a influencer Vox box and this is one of the worst reviews I've ever written. It was bad. I don't know if I have a video or if it was just a regular review, but the brush, it's really skinny at the bottom and really fat at the top and it's just a nightmare. This is the Revlon. It's a lash curler that had a light that you press and it lit up, but I didn't use that at all. It wasn't very strong. But oh well, it's not great though. I prefer my other one. I have a bunch of these blackhead pore strips from Pilot 10. I bought these on eBay. I never really liked them. I'd rather just buy like a legit blackhead pore strip. I have a very old sample of Egyptian Magic. I'm only getting rid of this because it's like, I mean, it says 36 months, but these, I feel like they do expire sooner than that. But I still have my full size one and I still love it. I have the Nivea Men Sensitive Skin Aftershave Balm. Remember when this became a popular thing for primer? I did really enjoy it for primer, and I think I talk about it in my declutter for it. I might not. This? It's, I'm pretty sure it's expired by now. Well, you want it? Never mind, not getting rid of it. Steven's taking it from me. So that's not getting decluttered. Yay for recycling. So I have the NYX Lip of the Day. I have the Mineral Fusion Gel Top Coat Nail Care. And I think this one might be vegan, but probably not. It's probably just cruelty-free, but it's very natural. This took about a year of using it, and then it just completely stopped working. Like, it just globs up and makes a giant mess, which is disappointing, but it's also natural, so I know they're not using chemicals or anything, but I want a top coat to last me more than a year. I have this MAC Matchmaster Foundation. I have the LA Girl Pro Concealer, HD Concealer. This one is very clumpy, but I talk about that in the declutter. Eyeshadows. This is the Impala Matte Floor Shock Nail Polish. I am getting rid of a few other nail polishes in here as well, other than the one that I just mentioned. And those will be part of the nail polish declutter. This is the Volume Style. Oh, there's lashes stuck to this. That's creepy. This is the Volume Style's 18 Hour Lash Extension Mascara. This is the purple one. And I did like the pink one better, which was the Curl and Hold. But this is still good, but I still recommend checking out the Lash Princess one. These are Physicians Formula Gel Eyeliners, and I don't know. If you know what year these came out, please let me know. I inherited these and I've never seen these before, and I have a feeling they're like 20 years old, but I mean, I might be wrong. Soft Lips Cube. I really enjoyed these. I got these from Chic Advisor, I'm pretty sure. So I have the Nutri Professional Amazonless Brazilian Smoothing Treatment. This is part two. I have part one and part three because I just did it the other day for the first time, and I can't give any sort of review right now because I want to wash my hair several weeks in a row first to make sure it doesn't just fade away after one wash. But I will tell you that upon the first wash when doing the treatment, it did work. But wait for that review. I'm sure you'll be very interested if you are interested in Brazilian keratin treatments that you can do at home. But that is it. This is what I used for my empties, and that was completely filled and spilling over. And I'm excited to be done and have all of those things going to the garbage, minus the aftershave balm, because Steven wants that. But I am going to go eat now. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Give it a thumbs up if you did. If you want me to do actual videos again, I've mainly just been doing the declutter videos. But let me know if you want me to go back to making actual videos, or if you're okay with just the declutter style ones. But yeah, subscribe if you haven't already, and if you want to see more. And I will see you very soon. Bye.